Welcome to the Bantha Tail End of Space, otherwise known as Tatooine. Hope you enjoy heat, Captain. It's the closest you'll get to landing on a sun, unless you're really unlucky.
If there's credits in it, I'll go just about anywhere.
An attitude like that will take you far in this galaxy. We're here because of a crime lord named Diago Hixon, the closest thing Noctrean ever had to a rival. Diago was always trying to one-up Noct. They fought for territory, bragging rights, and the occasional woman. The battles were legendary.
What's all that to me?
Diago celebrated Noct's death by raiding one of his storehouses. Stole an advanced Gree sensor computer. Priceless technology. To find Noctrean's fortune, we need to pry that sensor computer out of Diago's sticky fingers.
That could be trouble.
I haven't even gotten to the trouble yet. No one's seen Diago in years. He only communicates through his lieutenants. One of those lieutenants, a Nikto named Tukreek, promised to help. You need to meet him.
Where do I find our new best friend?
Tukreek owns a club in the desert outside Anchorhead. He's expecting you. Good luck, Captain.
Welcome, Captain. The lovely Risha has excellent taste in business partners. A face like yours attracts a lot of attention in a place like this. You'll never have to buy yourself a drink.
If you smell anything else, let me know.
I'm sorry to say this, but you've come in a bad time to do business. Things are intense.
What's wrong? You got problems with the local lawman?
It's much worse than that.
Hey, pretty face! You don't belong here.
I'm not looking for any trouble.
Then you definitely don't belong here.
Excuse me, but I suddenly feel an urge to put away all the breakable things.
I'm only a weary traveler. There's plenty of room here for both of us, my friend.
You're not my friend, got it?
I'm sure she'd buy you a drink if you gave her the chance.
I'm not thirsty.
You want to leave me alone. You want to stop noticing me.
You're really starting to annoy me. Men! Let's show Pretty Face what we do with people who annoy me.
If you want to pick a fight, why not pick me?
You got a big mouth. I'm gonna enjoy shutting it. Men! Kill them both!
I wish this hadn't ended in violence, but it was brave of you to intervene.
I figure I'm here for a good reason.
Your attitude is unexpected, but welcome. My name is Nariel Prydance. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm looking for Vavarone Zaire, an agent of evil and servant of the Sith Empire. Have you heard of her?
Is there a reason I should tell you anything?
Zaire is a being of vast darkness and a grave threat to the galaxy. I hear she's taken an interest in the local underworld, so I came to observe these criminals and gain information.
Looks like this resource is a dead end.
Yes, it's best I move on. I sense you're destined for greater things than consorting with common criminals. I must continue my search for Vavarone Zaire. May the Force be with you.
I thought she'd never leave. Look at his mess. Our gang has enough problems without Jedi chasing Sith through our territory.
The infamous Diago Hixon has trouble?
Our organization is under attack by a gang of Geonosians. Last week they took over our spice warehouse. Killed everyone, including a fellow lieutenant who had the only way of contacting Diago.
What do you mean, the only way to call your boss?
Iago hates it when we bother him. He got so angry, he killed a Krayt dragon, gave us lieutenants one fang to share. Only the lieutenant with the Krayt dragon fang can speak to Diago, and you helped kill the men I was sending to get it.
You've got a brilliant plan, right?
The way I see it, this is at least partly your fault. If you want your sensor computer, get me that Krayt dragon fang.
It's been a while since I broke a sweat. Might be fun.
My deceased associate kept the fang at the spice warehouse. Place is crawling with Geonosians. Won't be easy. Discouraging those Geonosians from sticking around will give us leverage with the boss. Just a suggestion. I'm heading for Diago's summer palace at these coordinates. Meet me there with the Krayt dragon fang.
Well, I'm pleased Diago finally responded to my provocation. I was expecting a bit more. Is that absurd little trophy the reason Diago sent you?
I'm here in my own business, lady.
You ran past the spice storehouses to fetch a bone. Interesting business. My name is Vavarone Zare. I'm interested in discussing a bargain with Diago Hickson.
I'm trying to get a meeting with Diago myself.
Yes. It's easier to get an appointment with the Dark Council. I've been prodding Diago for weeks. Raid a business here, kill a lieutenant there. It's like he hasn't noticed. I thought sending the Geonosians to raid this operation would surely draw him out. But all I've got is you.
Maybe he just doesn't have time for chit-chat.
Grand Moffs tremble before me. How powerful must Diago be not to care what I do to him? I'm seeking a small crimson box. One curio of many in Diago's personal collection. I'll give him whatever he wants for the box. But I need to arrange a meeting. Can you do that?
Are you looking to hire me?
If you serve me, you serve yourself. For your assistance, you'll receive a gift few beings ever enjoy. The pleasure of my company. You'll be the only member of your species who experiences me as something besides a master. I offer the chance of a lifetime. All I ask is that you arrange a meeting for me with Diago.
We can work something out. How do I contact you?
I scanned your holofrequency. I'll contact you. Don't take too long arranging things, or I'll have to employ more aggressive means of getting Diago's attention.
You come up with saying that by yourself?
Ah, the Krayt dragon fang. And in perfect condition. I'm deeply impressed with how you handled those Geonosians, Captain.
Remember that Sith we heard about? She controls the Geonosians, and she wants to meet Diago.
The Sith is behind the attacks on our operation? How do you know?
For a being of pure evil, she was surprisingly forthcoming.
Typical Sith. Start negotiations by blasting everything in sight. Let's hope that Jedi from my club puts the Sith out of our misery. We're going to an underground water well the natives call the Light Spring. The boss turned it into his private retreat. Now that we have the Fang, he'll let us into... Oh! What now?
Kukri! The palace is under attack! Imperial commandos! They're tearing us apart, breaching the security doors!
Diago will be furious if this palace falls to the Empire. Only one thing to do. Bring the Imperials and meet me at the Light Spring.
You're gonna leave me to clean this up?
I'm not abandoning you. I just don't want to die. Good luck. See you at the Light Spring.
Hello again. I was afraid you might have forgotten our agreement, so I sent some friends to jog your memory.
Call off your attack dogs, lady.
Gladly. All you have to do is honor your commitment. You promised to arrange a meeting for me with Diago. I want it. Now.
Diago's at a place called the Light Spring. I'll send you the coordinates.
See? That wasn't so hard. I just sent the all-clear signal to my soldiers. They're retreating as we speak. Oh, or perhaps not.
What's the matter? You can't find the exit?
Not exactly. Apparently, little Nariel has decided to poke her lightsaber where it doesn't belong. She's killing my soldiers at the palace's main door. Be a dear and throw her off our trail. Then meet me at the Lightspring. I'll see you there.
They wouldn't surrender. Why don't they ever surrender?
I don't think they hear too good through those helmets.
Please don't make jokes. People have died. I'm disappointed to see you in this place after our last conversation. I thought you'd learned to stop associating with criminals. Why are you here?
I'm just an innocent bystander here. Seriously.
I doubt we share the same definition of innocent. I heard about this palace back at the club. I came hoping to find Vavarone's heir, but it seems I've just missed her. If you know anything about the Sith's current whereabouts, please tell me.
Rumor is, she's got a hideout under the spaceport.
I never felt her presence when I was an anchorhead. Strange. I sense I'm running out of time to find Zaire. I should go. Don't take this the wrong way, but I hope our paths never cross again. May the Force be with you.
First the Sith, now this. Distraction after distraction, Tukrik. Annoying.
The captain is here on important business. The Sith came uninvited, boss.
The Sith's with me. It's nice having friends on the dark side.
We're the best friends to have.
You're a fool if you believe that. If you're wondering, I followed you here. Didn't believe your story for a moment.
It wasn't personal. Zaire made the better offer.
You stabbed me in the back. The boss will kill you for this.
You had every chance to do the right thing and failed. Now you'll suffer the consequences.
Empty chatter, like fingernails on transparent steel. I will silence. Who is that?
Captain, haven't heard from you in a while. Everything all right?
I got things under control.
Seems like it.
Oh, beautiful girl. So beautiful.
Wait, is that him? You're with Diago?
I want to see her again. Now!
She, doesn't seem to be answering her holo.
Then bring her to me. She is mine.
Diago, dear, I can offer you so much more. Just as soon as we rid ourselves of this Jedi.
Afraid to fight me alone, Sith?
Silence! The only voice here should be mine!
Diago, you're every bit the monster Vavarone Zaire is. You will both pay. You want to lay down your weapons. You want to surrender.
Does your little hand-waving thing ever work?
Why must you be so difficult? It would have been so much better if you'd surrendered.
No more! I find a beautiful girl myself! Droids! Kill everyone! But I didn't do anything! Everyone!
Oh!
Poor Nereal. Never had a moment's pleasure in her brief lifetime. It's almost sad.
If we actually cared, I'm sure it would be a tragedy.
A shame you aren't Force-sensitive. You'd make a lovely Sith. You've been ever so helpful. Let's discuss your compensation. Tell me your heart's desire, my dear.
I think I could learn a few things from you.
A would-be apprentice. How sweet. I'd be happy to share a few morsels of wisdom with you. Here, settle in next to me. How do you feel, my dear? Wiser, I hope.
The fashion tips alone were worth it.
Remember what I said about Alderaan. It's the only way you'll get invited to the best parties. I believe that concludes our business. I'll take my prize and be on my way. Such a gorgeous box. A delectable shade of crimson, don't you agree?
What's in that box, anyway?
You wouldn't understand. Bargaining with you was a pleasure. Farewell.
Nogdrayan. That's all I hear. What was it like to fight Nogdrayan? The next time some fool asks me that, I'll bury this holo recording in his forehead and play it back for the survivors. Nogdrayan was never a true gangster. Not like me. He just pretended. People think I fought him because he was more successful. Because he made me number two. Because he stole my wife. Lies! I fought him because he was no more a gangster than I am a senator. Nock was a con artist. The whole underworld was his mark. He was using us for something. Don't know what. But I do know he never gave a damn about being king of the underworld. It was all just a game. At least that pile of filth is finally dead. I raided his storehouse just to be sure. He never came. I'm still alive, and he's not. I won. You hear that, Nock? I won!
Wasn't sure I'd see you alive again, much less with that sensor computer. How did you get it?
Diago Hickson passed away unexpectedly. Left me a generous inheritance.
He's dead? Good. I mean, for your reputation. Sorry I didn't get a chance to chat with him before he died. My holo malfunctioned.
Really? You had technical difficulties?
Happens all the time. The suns here play havoc with comm frequencies. With that sensor computer installed, this freighter will be a first-rate scout vessel. I'll patch it into the ship's rectenna before takeoff. You should notice a difference right away.
I expect to be warned whenever there's trouble around.
The way things go for us, we'll have to reset the alarm every other parsec. Let's leave this sandball in our rear thrusters, Captain. Nocturne's fortune is out there waiting for us.
That sounds like slavery. Or worse, marriage. No thanks. I got no hold on you.
Nothing worse than coming to the realization that your parents were right. Can't stop thinking about Rona. My folks always said she'd come to no good in the big city. And there she is, a stooge for some spice smugglers.
Would you rather she'd been murdered with the rest of them?
Is that the choice? Death or hawking spice? I wanted something better for Rona. It's not like I didn't see it coming. Dr. Hope. I just didn't want to think that was really who Rona had fallen in with. That's what I get for trying to see the best in folks.
I need you up and shooting, not sitting in your bunk brooding.
Oh, trust me. I've mastered the brooding shot. I don't plan to stop giving anyone the benefit of the doubt. If I trust the wrong guy, maybe I get hurt. But if I'm too scared to help someone who really needs it, who knows how many people will suffer?